Alright guys, it's been a few days. We're just heading back to the last teepee where I added a few sticks onto the structure we found. Just want to see if anything has changed. I doubt it, but you never know. Nope, it looks just as messy as when I left it. There's still 9 sticks here. I'm ready to call these things just natural because there's no footsteps in the snow. I mean, it's not kids building these. I don't know, guys. We can go check our gifting log though and see if that Kong that Gage found that we left up there, if it's still there. I didn't put any trail cameras on the log or anything, so if it's gone, all we can do is look for tracks, right? But if it's still there, it's still there. Let's go take a look. Still there. So I've actually had an image sent to me by one of the guys actually that I'm doing this podcast with. In the little town out in the middle of the bush that we grew up in, a friend of ours was out hiking, apparently miles from anywhere, and he came across this trackway. Now I only have one image, and it's not a great image, but what he was telling me is that these footprints, or what he says were footprints, are 10 inches wide, 24 inches long, with a 2.5 to 3 foot space in between each one. So now I've looked at it, and I'm going to tell you guys what I think. Here, you take a look first. Here's the image. Let me know what you guys think. Take a look at this. Totally legit. He took this way out in the middle of nowhere. So when I looked at this, what I thought is, right away, moose. Okay, now he said that he couldn't see any hoof prints in there. He said it actually looked like toe prints, but I didn't get any overhead looking down image, okay? So what I can see from looking at this image that we have here is what happens is the moose walks through the bush, the cow, the mother, and the calf walks behind. The mother steps in her own tracks as she walks, so you get an elongated track with no drag in between because they have really long legs. And then you have a calf, the baby moose, that follows the mother, and it actually steps in her footprints as well. So this leads to an even longer track. Now, without me being there, without me seeing these tracks, that would be my guess. And if you look at the first couple of footprints here, it looks kind of churned up to me. Hard to say without a better picture and without being there, guys. I just thought I'd share this with you. Somebody did send me this. Let me know what you think down below. So right now, guys, I'm struggling with a computer issue. As you guys know, I brought my new system into Timmy Joe's and he confirmed that the board is in fact the issue again. So I bought a brand new MSI motherboard, had to RMA it, send it back in on my dime. They make you pay for shipping and everything. They sent me a new one, which could be a refurbished something they had in the shop. It's probably not a new one. And it was basically doing the same thing. It wouldn't post, and I was getting another LED on the board saying video card error, which I know was not the video card because the video card came right out of my machine, which was working. I created videos for you guys the same day I took it out and put it in the other board. Anyway, Timmy Joe has confirmed that it's a bad MSI board, and I've got to send it back again, go through this whole paste. So I've been working on that issue since November, so I'm kind of bummed out. I'm editing on my old computer, it's torturous. So after today's video, guys, I think it might be a while till I do another one. It's just so time consuming. Actually, I do have a video upcoming that I'll post for you guys this weekend. Friends of mine have started a new podcast on, paranormal, conspiracy stuff, right up our alley, Bigfoot stuff. And they wanted me to go on. It's their second episode this week, so we'll be filming that. And I'll post a link to that on the channel. But other than that, I can't promise a whole lot, guys, because it's just torturous editing on this old computer. I honestly think my laptop would be faster, but I've got the laptop at the office for my real job, so I can't do that either. But for today, enjoy this video. Gage and I are going to take a little walk, then tonight we're going to do a bit of star stuff. And we'll just, fly by the seat of our pants like we always do around here, guys. If you get more, you get more. Depending on how bored Gary is feeling. I'm pretty bored. COVID has got me just going crazy, but... Just heard a tree knock. From somewhere. It's hard to tell with the dog chomping stuff beside me, but he heard it too. He looked up too. Can you hear that wind? It's up in the treetops and it's just swirling out here. Feels creepy right here. We're just following a deer trail through the bush. We're not on any of my trails. And I can hear the wind whipping around in the trees up there. I've noted that before, that when I hear the wind in the distance like that, I get that creepy feeling as well. Is that an intuition thing? Is that an evolutionary thing? I don't know if you guys can hear the wind. But it's blowing around up there, way up there in the tops of the trees. Trees rubbing together in the wind, maybe? Just gonna show you guys a little clip from out on the deck last night. Got some beautiful star photos and clarification on what the flashing light was in the last two UFO story videos. Everybody repeat after me. Geosynchronous communications satellite in stationary orbit. That is what our flashing, blinking light up there that we've been watching the last few nights is. Confirmed. So I had a few people tell me to do some research on these geosynchronous communication satellites. Okay, and what they are, they've actually been put up since the 60s. And I didn't realize that you could put a satellite in orbit and not have it moving across the night sky. So what they do is they put them up at the equator and they are in sync with the Earth's spin. And they do that so that the communication satellite dishes down here on Earth can be pointed once at the satellite and don't have to be readjusted. Okay, now these satellites up there are spinning. So what happens is, in the case of the one we're looking at, every 28 seconds, there's a panel on there that's, as it's spinning, catching sunlight and causes a glint or a flash that we detect up there. I have never seen this before I started using the night scope. I never noticed it, but apparently they've been doing this since the 60s. Now, you crazy buggers that kept telling me or trying to tell me that this was some kind of communications tower, and I was telling you guys, no, it's got to be hundreds of miles up there. Listen to how high these things are. 35,000 kilometers. I said hundreds of miles. That's 22,000 miles. If you look at the positioning of my camera in the last two videos, you see that it's pointed way up there. So unless I had a tower right here in my backyard and we were just pointing it up 100 meters, it was definitely no tower. So that's what it is, guys. It's a communication satellite in geosynchronous orbit. So if you guys noticed, I only saw one satellite last night, which was kind of strange. And as I was tracking it across the sky, it just disappeared. I don't know, I haven't noticed that any of the other nights we've been out there, but. All right, I'm turning around. I'm heading back to the house. It is 3 o'clock, David Pilates' witching hour between 3 and 4. He always says that's when most of the people disappear in the bush, so. And I feel creeped out today. I think it's just the wind up in the trees. I don't know. The dog has been acting a little strange too, barking, which he usually doesn't. So we're gonna make our way 45 minutes back to the house. If I hear anything else, I'll let you guys know. If not, like I say, stay tuned. Times are a little tough right now on the editing side of things. So hopefully I'll get a couple more videos out for you guys this week, but no promises. Thanks for watching, guys.